Welcome to another Echo Works production of Steel Rails. Steel Rails is produced for the Grand Rapids Model Railroad Club. If you would like more information about this club, it will appear at the end of this production.
Thank you. My name is Orton Tugger Jr. This is my father, Orton Tugger Sr., 46-time Lumberjack World Champion. This is my uncle, Jack Coger, a 5-time World Champion. I myself have won five, pardon me. Now, you're probably looking at this. And you're maybe a little confused about what all we do here. Now, for those of you who haven't seen Lumberjack Sports or ESPN or ABC Broadway Sports, it's a little unusual, I guess you could say. Kind of unique. Back in the days of yesteryear, back in the logging camps, even here in West Virginia, but particularly on the West Coast, the man worked from dusk until dawn, 6 o'clock in the morning to 6 o'clock in the afternoon, 5 to 6 days a week. And on weekends, they had little means of recreation. Usually what they did is they drunk themselves into a stupor. Now, many of you can attest to that. I don't know if I can myself, but when they were drunk, they used to challenge one another. See who could chop them along, hop on top of a big log, double-headed axe, and see who could chop the longest from his log. The man who could chop the longest was known as the bull of the woods. In some cases, they would take their cross-cut saws out of the woods and use the trail to make trees in one day. These men were known as lumberjacks, or woodhicks, as they were called here in West Virginia. Now, we are not quite the men that they were. We do things a lot simpler and a lot faster. And we will try to give you a little glimpse of what lumberjack sports is. They, our goal is to introduce you to this sport. The sport that many of our forefathers had done throughout the lumbering and the timber business in the United States. What do you want to do, Dad?
All right. Do you push anything on this fishing right there? Pull right there.
One of the first things I want to do here, I see a fella that I've known since 1959, comes from Pennsylvania, and he was a fella, it was the MC at the Cherry Springs Carnival, we always called it, and we all still go to it, and I've been going since 1959. I want to introduce a good friend of mine, Marshall Case has turned me on and let me chop many times at the Cherry Spring Carnival. We're lucky to have that fella right there. He's done a lot for the sport.
When the West Virginia boys come to Cherry Springs, 2 carloads of them, they always took home at least half of the prize money.
We're going to have Jack and my brother Jack and my son Arden Jr. here. We're going to have him put us on a little exhibition cross-cut sawing here, like we used to cut the timber in the woods with the old cross-cut saws before the power saws come along. And they're going to cut 2 cuts through this 9-inch canch here, and I better get on this log too and help Shell hold it down. They might jerk it off of there. It ain't nailed too solid. And when we get them started there, I'll give them a count or something. I'll get them started 1, 2, go or something, and they'll cut us 2 cuts off of this log. You boys ready? 1, 2, go! All right, that time was 8.88. That's 8 seconds and 88 hundredths of a second on 2 cuts.
Down cut, down and up and down.
They'll make 3 cuts. A down cut, an up cut, and a down cut.
Down we're going to go with our hands on the log.
Hands on the log. Which saw do you think's going to win?
The north one.
Who's the most champion here?
Contestants ready. On your marks, get set, go. Quite a difference, wouldn't you say?
Michael Jack made the three cuts in this log in 3.75 seconds. As I was watching down on both cuts, I believe he finished all three before my father finished the first one.
So I may hit a little harder, but he may put in two to my one. Now, who's one or two counts more just depends upon the axeman.
All right, we'll gather around here, and I'm going to give these boys a countdown, just like we will in Webster Springs next weekend. And we'll see which one of them wins there. They usually cut these small wood really good, both of them. And Jamie, are you ready?
Yep.
Jack, are you ready? All right, I'm going to give you a one, two, go. Whoa. That was a pretty good contest there, though. I figured there's about 1 second difference in them boys are cutting there.
This right now.
They throw 20 feet. The idea is the bullseye to be 5 feet from the ground, and for the target to be 20 feet from the line on which they throw. Let me get out of your way. That is a bullseye.